Hey guys, how are you today? Alrighty. So, I told you already in previous videos that for me, February is not only about showing your love to your family, your children, your spouse, but yourself. And remembering those that you love who have passed is also, for me, is part of the whole month of February. Not the least of which because my grandmother, who was very near and dear to all of us in the family, passed away in February, about 3 years ago. And I think she was like 99. So she had a really good long life, but she was a very sweet, dear lady. And this is her photo when she was, I think, in her early 20s, if not late teens. Beautiful, right? And so we're going to do a remembrance piece of her. So I've got her photo. I actually have it twice because my printer was out of running out of ink. And it printed it this way. And I really kind of wanted it to be the original, like, sepia tone. So I printed it again. I have a quote that actually I think is appropriate to my grandmother that says, biggest often doesn't even lead to happiness. It's the small things that make people happy. She definitely believed that. She also never ever went to visit anybody empty-handed. We always used to tease her. She always used to bring a pound cake. She would bring other things sometimes, but always she had a pound cake. I have a textured piece of packaging here that I did a while ago on a previous YouTube video. I'll try to remember to link in the description below. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it or not, but it is interesting and I may want to use it. So I have it out just in case. I have some old distressed lace that I actually distressed myself. I have a piece of a woven, printed, old-fashioned style of fabric from my dear friend Cindy Utter. My grandmother always never went anywhere without a handkerchief, and I still carry on that tradition, and so does my daughter. My grandmother frequently had these type of handkerchiefs with the crocheted lace, delicate lace edge, and this is one, this is not hers that I'm aware of, but this was in my box of collage fabrics that I have here sitting in my studio. This is hers, and it was just like this when I inherited it. It is a jar of buttons. It literally was like this, so we may want to use some of these, probably with the card and all, on there. What else do we have here? I have these. So these both were my grandmother's. They both have the things in them they originally did when I inherited them, plus I've added a few things to them. This smaller one, these were some of her eyeglass frames. The smaller one, I've added a few little bits and toys. This is actually from my grandfather on the other side of the family. My grandmother was very Catholic, and she and my great-grandmother had a lot of these medallions and things around. So I do think I want to maybe use one of these in the project. And I'm actually thinking, every time I've gone in here, I'm thinking this one. There's also this teeny miniature Bible, which is interesting in here. So that maybe, there's also a Red Cross card of hers. She was very philanthropic, not only with donating blood, but, she gave to charity on a very regular basis. And let's see, this is Catholic Ladies Aid Society, evidently branch 63. Some of this I haven't looked at since she passed, to be honest with you. There are some, I forget what these are called. I'm no longer a practicing Catholic. I don't remember. This is one of her address stamps. And I think that's the old house. Yeah, Kitty Matt Place. Here's another pouch. What does this have in it? Oh, that's pretty funny. So there's this little pouch here, just vinyl with a, you know, snap. It has, I'm not going to show you this because it actually has my home address on it and my home telephone number. And then it has some of her old address labels. That's pretty interesting. We're going to take that one in, hide that. I'm not sure why that's in there, but that's from a chandelier. Oh, there are one of her handkerchiefs in here. And rosaries. She had rosaries. I have boxes of her rosary beads. And I've added a few little toys and a Hot Wheel and things like that to the box. So I'm going to keep out the things that I think I might want to use. And what I don't use will go back in the box. And then I have this larger round one. And I love these boxes of hers. I didn't even know she had them until she passed, which was a shame. There was a third one, a canister, that I actually sent to my sister. And if I'm not mistaken, I put some more extra things in it when I sent it to her. This one was just like this when I inherited it. And it has some of her crocheted pieces unfinished in it. And it has this needle book, some gummed labels, thread, a bobbin. I don't know what that is. This is a piece of one of these sock darner things. I'm not sure why that piece is in there. She never threw anything away, which we always kind of knew, but we found out when she passed really how bad it was. What is this? Oh, that's funny. I don't know exactly what that is. Does anybody know? It's cute. It's cute, whatever it is. Maybe it's supposed to hold thread or something? Maybe needles in the inside? Yeah, there are needles in the inside. Maybe thread on the outside? Maybe it's some sort of little pocket sewing kit. It's very cute. So anyway, so we're going to use some of these pieces in this piece for her. I want to try to keep the size of it fairly small so that it fits back in my journal. So I am going to get started with that. I'm going to speed forward through the process. I am also going to use probably some cardboard. I've got an Amazon box here next to me. So I do think I'm going to use that too. So I am going to get started and I'll speed forward through it and I'll be right back.
Thank you.
Okay, here is the finished piece, and while it's still wet, I love it. And I can't wait for it to dry, and I can hang it up in here. It turned out much bigger than I thought it was going to be, but I honestly was just having fun and doing what felt right and not thinking about it too much. At least 50% of the pieces on here are things that she personally owned and or her picture. And I did, as you saw at the end, back it with a piece of scrap piece of mat board just to stiffen the whole thing. And I used goop glue to attach everything and or heavy gel medium. Actually a couple of staples. I actually kind of like the way the stapler kind of looks. The grungy look of the stapler. So just take some of your bits and pieces that you may have that either actually belonged to or remind you of that person in your life who has passed on that you love and miss, and create a remembrance piece of them, something that you can remember with fondness, with a smile instead of tears. This is definitely going to remind me of my grandmother, and although it's too big to fit in my journal for this year, I think that's okay because I think it needs to hang by my desk and here in the office. That's it for today, everybody. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Join the My Year 2017 Facebook group if you'd like to see more things like this and be part of what's going on over there. We're having a lot of fun. Support my channel if you can by shopping in my Etsy shop. I would really appreciate that. And the links for everything are in the description below. And don't forget the most important thing. Go out and have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys. Hey, guys. You thought we were done, didn't you? Only those of you who watch my videos to the end are going to see this part. Unless I put a warning in the beginning, which I might. So I decided after looking at this, and it's mostly dry, it's not completely dry, that I really wanted to add some pen marks. Just rough pen marks. I should have probably done this before I put everything together. Oh, that's okay. This is a Pilot Varsity disposable fountain pen. And then I have a gold paint pen. There's some gold on here from this ribbon that my grandmother had at the bottom in the fringe, and also from the pin part of it that I kept and put it on here. And I really want to just some gold. Yeah. I might want to. Let's see. Got stuff on my hand. So I'm going to just come in here with a little bit of the Sharpie pen, a little bit at a time, and then before it dries, I'm going to come in with the baby wipe and just smudge it a little bit. Doing this with the baby wipe means that after it dries, it's not going to go anywhere, unlike a gelato or something. And if I'm going to do it this way, I have to be really careful because I don't have tons of control over my left hand. Not only is it my non-dominant hand, but it's got some numbness going on since I had surgery on my shoulder. I like that. Yep. That just adds a little something to it, don't you think? Yeah, I like that a lot. All right, that's it. Now we're done. All right, see you later. Bye, guys.